Hey, what's up, guys? This is the box opening of the Colt Delta Elite. So let's check it out. Let's open this box up. It's probably a day after Christmas because I can't upload it in real time, but let's check this thing out. I did pop the thing open. I didn't open it just yet, so let's see if there's... Okay, look at that. Whoops. There it is, folks. Delta Elite in the packaging. Looks like there's two magazines here. All right. It's in the packaging. Now, the story of this is I believe Colt built this recently. I just want to show you. So this is a hot off the press Delta Elite. Maybe the last one for 2012. I don't know. Who knows? The person that brought this in for me, thank you very much for bringing this into me and for hooking me up. I greatly appreciate it. And I will be in touch with you soon. He actually got me a Cobra mag. Look at this thing, guys. Best magazine for 10mm. He said that the space plate sticks way out, so it's not a flush fit on the Delta Elite, but it does carry 9 rounds. Hold on a second. Let me take it out of its nice packaging. Nice. All right. Let's take a little closer look at this Colt Delta Elite. Very nice. Nice and shiny. I like that. Really cool. I don't really like the black long trigger. I mean, I do, but this trigger looks kind of chintzy in a little way, you know, but whatever. It's all right. I'm just looking it over, see if there's any imperfections, because this is literally a hot off the press Delta Elite. I don't see any idiot scratch there. Mainspring housing, everyone says it's plastic. I don't know if it really is. It's got the hump right there. That's really cool. I like that old school style. And the beaver tail, you know, old school. Now, I know when I was shooting a guy's Delta Elite at the range, his beaver tail was actually biting me, this part right here, just the way it came out, I guess, but anyways. This is pretty much a no-frills 1911, guys, you know? Nothing beveled there, really. I'm just trying to show you this. The grips, infamous red triangle, signifies the Delta. Let's look at the slide to frame fit if we can. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. Huh. Standard old sights, combat hammer. I like that. I like that, guys. It's like a nice touch, you know, instead of the old skeletonized trigger and the hammer and all that. But I like that hammer there. But it looks like it's they did a good job. You know, it's just sight safety here is nothing special, but standard old sight safety. Doesn't look like to see any imperfections so far, but that's not just, let's see, looks still got the factory grease up on this stuff. Looking good. I think I want to take the thing apart though, see what it looks like on the inside. Well, I'm pretty excited about this, guys. A 1911 chambered in 10mm, the infamous Colt Delta Elite. Something I've always like had the you know wanted in the back of my mind, so I figured I'd get it. Thank you to the guy that brought this into me. I know he's watching, so thank you very much for getting this Delta Elite in for me. I really, really appreciate what you did for me. So, I also got a Cobra mag, as you can see right here. It's 9-rounder. And apparently, he said that let me slam this thing in there and see what it looks like. Hold on. Yeah, that's Cobra mag. That does look a little silly, huh? Well, oh well. I'm not really looking for looks. I wanted a mag that functioned 9 rounds. I believe a fellow YouTuber told me to check out Chip McCormick, as they have a 9-rounder that will fit flush like these OEMs or the Colt magazines for the Delta Elite, but yeah, it looks kind of silly. But that's all right. That's okay. Again, it's not for looks, it's for function. I just wanted something that would have, that could hold 9 plus 1, so 10 rounds in this 1911. Oh, pretty nice. Hold on a sec. Let me lock the action back open. We'll look and see what we can see in there. All right, I just locked the slide back, and guys, it must be the spring, but it was extremely tight. This gun is really tight. I wasn't expecting it to be like that. When I was racking the slide back, it was really, really tight. Like, I don't want to say less bear tight, but my Wilsons and Nighthawk Custom weren't this tight. So this is kind of interesting. It could be the spring, you know, resistance and all that. Maybe that's what it is. The spring is just really heavy. Can we see anything in there? It's kind of dirty, huh? It looks like they fired it at the factory. Still a lot of grease in there. Huh. See anything in there? Yeah, it's kind of dirty. I'll have to frog lube this, sorry. I'll have to frog lube this Colt Delta Elite all up because I want to see how that stuff works. But there you go, guys. Pretty excited about this. 10mm 1911. Yeah, I mean, I know I could have gone with, a Dan Wesson. I'm not a Kimber fan, so whatever there, but I could have gone with the Razorback. They had one used at a gun shop. And, I don't know, I just wanted the Delta Elite. Hold on. So here it is in a cocked and locked state. When I was shooting a guy's Delta Elite at the range, that beaver tail right there, because I like to have it high riding like this. And as you can see, I just remembered it biting me a little bit in the web of my hand like that. So like this. So, no big deal. And I like how this thumb safety is so, it's really tight. Everything's really tight on this 1911. And it's brand new and all, but I like that. It's really tight. Really nice. I'm really happy about this purchase, guys. Really happy. Look at all that grease coming out there. So, I don't see any flaws in the finish or any scratches or anything. Some of the one used Delta Elite I saw about 2 months ago, it was pretty scratched up. And that was a new production model, 2012 model. It looks like this thing will scratch easy. So, I guess, I don't know, just be careful with it, because I don't really know if I want to carry the Delta Elite. This is more of a novelty 1911 for my collection, but, I mean, I like the Glock 20 as a carry gun if I want to carry a 10mm, a full-size 10mm. Something like this, I don't know yet. We'll have to see what happens, but let's check out how this trigger feels. Safety off. Let's press this trigger. That's a heavy trigger pull for a 1911. That's like a carry trigger. I'd say, damn, that hammer's tight. Good though, I like that. I'd say about, I don't know, 4.5 pounds, maybe a little bit more. That's pretty heavy trigger for a 1911. But it doesn't bother me, but it's like a carry trigger, which is nice. I mean, I'm used to all different types of trigger pulls on 1911s, but and as you can see, this magazine here sits flush on the bottom versus that, as you saw, the Cobra mag that didn't sit flush. It looked kind of goofy, but the gunsmith that brought this in for me had an extra Cobra mag for a 10mm, and he just told me to take it. I mean, I paid him for it, but he just said, I have no use for it. It's brand new. So I took it. It didn't sit flush, like I showed you before, but hey, I wanted a 9-round mag so I can have a capacity of 10 rounds out of a 1911. If I ever decide to carry something like this, cosmetically, yeah, it's not going to look that cool, but what do I care? Now, I know somebody said check out Chip McCormick, 9-rounders for 10mm, so I will do that. And, geez, this is nothing to sneeze at. I mean, it's a lot of firepower, but I also got a bunch of, I have 100 rounds of this Underwood Delta Elite ammo for this Delta Elite. So I'll be really curious to see if this stuff even functions through the Delta Elite. But here, let's check some of this stuff out. It's gold dot bullet. So if any of you guys have ever fired this stuff through it, it's 180 grain coming out at about 1240 feet per second. Looks like that. This is some really good ammo. I'm beginning to really like Underwood. I think they are so reasonably priced, you'd be stupid not to check out their stuff. And let's hope their prices don't get jacked after this whole ordeal, but you never know. So I tried to get some more 10mm ammo from them, but they are sold out. Sold out of everything. Except for this load here. So I don't think, well, maybe they're sold out by now because they didn't have much left. But before I buy a ton more of this stuff, the Delta Elite formula, I want to make sure it freaking runs through this gun. Because if it doesn't, then I got a bunch of ammunition that I'll just have to fire through my Glock 20. Because the Glock 20 eats anything. 1911, they could be finicky. So we'll be very curious to see what this thing will eat and how it chokes and stuff like that. Guys, send me some private messages if you own a Delta Elite. You know, you want to make, you leave comments, please do. I'm just curious to get as much information as I can about the Delta Elite and what ammunition you use, what kind of springs, because this thing is, when I'm racking this slide, it's significant. When I'm pulling that slide back, it's pretty tough. Everything is extremely tight on this Delta Elite, which I'm, I'm kind of impressed that it's so tight, being just a standard old production gun. I mean, I think they just threw it together, so I think it's just a production gun. It's not custom. What kind of target ammo do you use? I got four boxes of this, the American Eagle, left over. But, see, I got 10 boxes of the Blazer because they're cheap. They're like, I don't know, $18 a box because I bought them in bulk. So, I don't know. Will Blazers, the aluminum cases, run through this Delta Elite? Or is it not good for it? I mean, I don't know. Or should I just use American Eagle? So, guys, leave some comments. If you want, private message me, because you can, you know, talk a lot more through PM instead of the comments. But, hey, do whatever you want. And that's about it, guys. I'm sorry I'm kind of discombobulated. I'm in a rush just because it is Christmas Day. I got to get to places. But have a happy new year, and I'll probably post a video before the new year anyways about the Delta Elite, because I have some stories coming. All right, guys, take it easy. And stay safe. And check 360 often. Later.